afternoon, everybody, and welcome to the Vertom Sports for the game between the International Korfball Federation Champions League Round 3. Ladies and gentlemen, the game between the Borgerhout, Groen-Wit and PKC, Vertom. I would like to introduce you both teams, starting with PKC Vertom. Thank you very much.
Hello everyone and welcome to the IKF Korfball Champions League Round 3. It's the final, PKC versus Borgerhout, and a decent crowd building just outside Antwerp and Herentals in Belgium. This is PKC's first appearance at the tournament because of the status that the Netherlands have in terms of the seeding that they've got. And they're up against the Borgerhout, who looked very, very good against Tuschilgen yesterday. Really enjoyed the style that they played, the enthusiasm and togetherness of the team. Well, they're going to need all those good points because they're up against really what is recognised as one of the best teams in the world in PKC. Both teams will go forward to the February 11th final Champions League, where they'll be joined by Fortuna and Florient. One from the Netherlands, one from Belgium. So there'll be two Belgian teams in that final. And all of the other lesser teams will be going through to the Challenger final. And I hope I don't have explained all that again. And we'll let the Korfball do the speaking for us. And that's Borgerhout in red starting us off. Early shot, nice control by Yanni Obagasti. Nice 2-2 set up, Obagasti for side, and bounces kindly for Yelmer Jonker. Pretty good PKC team, they're thereabouts in terms of the top of the Dutch league again. They're never far off from there. Can't remember the last bad team that they put out, and that's Oliver Weingarten, number 11, a distinctive face mask that he's got, gets a drive through. And our referee, one of our referees, Peter Busik from Slovakia, calls that a free pass, which Arjen Van Hoeligen will take. And he flips it to Oliver Weingarten to jump out. Nice goal. Interesting face mask he's got. Hopefully get a closer look at that. I'm not quite sure how he got that. It used a lot more for precautions nowadays. Richard Kunz sees the interception. I'm hoping Borgerhout can stay in this game and really trouble PKC, because PKC definitely like red hot favourites for this. But Borgerhout would have had a good night thinking about the good game they played and planning for the strategy that they're going to do to beat them. And I've got a feeling I'll have tried to go off the basket for that. Would have been pretty special if he'd have managed to do it. Good to see the Borgerhout crowd getting into it. A little bit of trouble pulling the structure they want. Narrow pay on, get the madpin on that one. City Schroeder drives again, nice. Hoeligen. Oliver Weingarten working hard at the post. Retention. Borgerhout not taking any risks at the moment, although that was definitely a risk to try and come round and block the ball coming to Oliver Weingarten. He's just a cheeky little one-handed little flick. And that's Glenn Powells, who ended up on the wrong side of that nice Olav goal. Other referee is from Turkey. Free pass comes to nothing. Let's have a look at what attacking we're going to see from this end. Jonker. Nice. Smooth, and Kunz trying to bend over backwards, but he's up against Yanni Armagasti, who's not only a good athlete, but a very experienced player as well. That's going to be an interesting matchup. And there's a pattern of the last four or five attacks where Borgerhout trying to put the ball into the inside and getting intercepted, and Kunst with his trademark one leg lift shot off the back there, very reliable. Again, no, passes it up to Jonker. Belgian boys were trying to be cheeky and try and drop and put some pressure on them. The great understanding between Jonker and Kunst. Good to see the Jonker's young boy smile that he's got. It's Roy van Laken who's at the post, just running the block now. Since our camera catches up. And it comes to nothing in the end. Good. Okay, so what tactics they got? So they're getting that boy collect quite easy, and obviously Pakistan giving that to them and then just trying to put pressure on the ball on the outside and the ball coming to the inside, and it's working for the Pakistan defense at the moment. And nice combination, ended up the Romy de Riker shot. And the other girl down there is Brett Zufek. There's Romy de Riker, nice. Good contest, Jonker. Oh, shot, just sat it up on the top, span it round, and then down it went. Two quick goals for Jonker, no one who's smiling. The shot from Borgerhout off the back was close, but the quite short attacks that they're getting. Van Hooligan, nice. A lot of space, difficult to follow him out that far with the amount of attacking power that Pakistan have got. There's Yarrow Pater, so enjoyed watching yesterday, mainly because he's got that really do or die attitude you just saw at the end before the camera cut away. And Borgerhout must be getting a little bit frustrated because they're not being able to play anywhere near the style that they were playing yesterday, but obviously a good defense will stop you doing that. Not quite sure there. I did see, was it Kunst go down? And early timeout. I'm assuming that is going to come from Belgium. We have got the coaches mic'd up, so as soon as they get in there, I'll go quiet, and perhaps we can have a listen to what some of these coaches are saying. As for the Borgerhout coach, this was a good time for a timeout.
Te veel mee even laat spelen. En niet altijd omdat ze druk zitten. Het is ook een beetje concentratie. Het is een beetje onder een indruk zijn. Er moet een eigen over zitten. Die stomme goal in de korf, die moeten proberen eruit te halen. Denk of het een shot is of een tweede kans. Als we alles aan hebben gedaan voor die rebound pakken, dan is dat maar zo. Die gaat incasseren. In aanval toe, opbrengen. Ze zijn er niet rustig genoeg aan toe. Je wilt te veel mee op hun tempo. En daarom hebben ze een fout als in aanval, omdat je mee onder een hoge afslag speelt. Kunnen wagen die momenten en brengt kwaliteit in aanval.
Okay, an impassioned plea there from the Borgerhout coach, and not quite too sure how much you understood. I'm not quite sure what he can say. Ended up with Pakistan getting the ball back. Poking the ball around nicely. Sana van der Werf, the player I like a lot, never turns a good shot down. Happy to play static post, and now Olive comes out and he has to use his long reach to avoid travelling there. Van der Werf gets her good solid shot up that she takes all the time, and Brett Zuved drops it in from the back, and Borgerhout in a lot of trouble at the moment as Pakistan are just rolling over them. Nice shot from Glenn Powells, and interesting collection. Is it Van Laken? Doesn't get it to go. Well, Nice easy post position for Jonker to allow Kunz to work on the outside with the assistance of Brett Zudweg. Boys combining again, good tempo out to Kunz. Good attacking from PKSA, but the collection from Yarrow Paters was legal and his opponent's was, his challenge wasn't. Didn't quite see where the free pass come from, but it is a free pass. Going to be taken by Glenn Powells. Doesn't get it back cleanly. Have to rebuild. Van Hooligan trying to looking to drop off to get that ball that's coming into the post. Nice easy movement, looking very calm and comfortable. Now Jonker tries to drive in, jumps out, and Zudweg collects nicely out to Kunst. Shot clock ticking down, there it resets, but Jan Amagasti takes it away from them. Glenn Powells, good collection from Elke Ledent. Gets another shot up, there's Daphne van der Boscher. That's perhaps considered like one of the better Borgerhout attacks. I think they got three shots in there. Still, it's a long time to go scoreless when at their level. It's a good collection by Romy de Rijker. Boys combining nicely. Good double. Kearns with his characteristic arm extension that he has in the shot. And then there's Romy de Rijker. Finds herself in a little bit of space, gets the loose ball. Packers will take all the good shots that come to them. And in the end, the ball fell to Elke Ledent for Borgerhout, and she can't convert the running in shot. And Richard Kearns drops it down, and the Packers steamroller just goes rolling on and over Borgerhout. Decent pressure from Yanni on Amagasti, but he wasn't going to get there, really. That's a nice exchange between Wim Schultmeier, the coach of PKC, and Richard Kunz. It's going to be Amagasti on the outside. Yarrow Paters was ready to collect that, but Yanni Amagasti, to the relief of the Borgerhout crowd, he gets one to drop finally. Sander van der Werf from the back. And Olaf trying the little flick into Iron Van Hooligan. Now the boys combine well. Decent shot. Did he leave his hand up there in celebration just a little bit prematurely? Van der Werf. Oh, it's just all packed. I say at the moment, they're just controlling everything that's coming off the court. Finally, it breaks down. A little bit better control from Borgerhout, and Paters from a long way out and gets blocked by Jelmer Jonker. Eventually the ball found his way back to him. It goes to the little shot, and Richard Kearns just couldn't let him take it. There we go. There's the first block. Paters gets it back, and we won't see that the block from Kearns, unfortunately, as Paters knocks that away. Quite a crowded post in terms of the way that Pakistan normally play, but there they spread it out very nicely, and Jonker had the beatings of Amagasti there, but couldn't get the ball through. Glenn Powells forces one up as the clock is ticking down, and Roy Van Laken thought he had just got that cheeky one up. Pleasant exchange with the referee. Even the crowd can't believe what happened there, and I'm still waiting to see what the decision was. I assume it's gone against Roy Van Laken. Everybody seemed to enjoy it. in the meantime, I think it is quarter time, and we're just seeing some replays. And there's Oliver Mwangan. Yeah, I think that was where he did try and play off the post, and that's where he did score the cheeky one underneath.
Concentreer, niet inspringen, geen foutjes. Concentreren bij vakwissel. Let's go.
Wim Schultmeijer and Jennifer Tromp, coaches of PKC, used to work together for the Dutch national team, and they've had a couple of good seasons at PKC. Didn't win the final last year, but sometimes that happens when you turn up the Ahoy and you meet a good team like Fortuna. They'll be looking to get revenge this year again, of course. And this Champions League has added another good date to the Korfball calendar, where we're going to see PKC and Fortuna and the two top Belgian teams, as well as giving the other lesser nations and lesser clubs a chance in the Challenger tournament. And it's meant a lot of extra international Korfball throughout the summer, and hopefully you've enjoyed most of it. Okay, and the second quarter starts poorly for Borgerhout, let's say that. Kunz working on Amagaste, and in the end he draws the foul out of him. Amagaste choosing to come from the side. It's difficult to decide what to do with Kunz because he shoots pretty well. In the end, they forced him to give it back to Jelmer Jonker, who misses. Glenn Powell's defended by Van Weingarten. Now, nice ball to Van Laken. Drops it down from the back. They're finally getting a little bit of the rhythm and confidence that we saw yesterday into their game today. Kunz. Oh, that was close. Peters almost gave a penalty away. He's out of position now, and it ends up with, I assume that was Rami de Rijker. Nice, great finish. A lot of the confusion started with Jaro Peters going looking for the ball and not getting it. Nice moment, Amagaste, and Jaro Peters even better. He tried a couple of those cheeky shots yesterday. Finally got one to go. Good to start to see some smiles on their faces, and it's going to make for a better game for everybody. Van Weingarten. A little bit messed up. They have ended up with the girls on the inside. Van Hoeligan shooting from the outside, but that's not a great attack from Pankasay. Peters, long way out. Oh, good shot. Amagaste looked like he got fouled. Referee thought so as well. Moved to the inside, ended up giving it to Peters, who just takes the off-rhythm shot. Amagaste goes and gets it. This is better from Borgerhout. Nice. Peters working on Kunz. Takes good shot. Great shot. Yes, Borgerhout finally got their rhythm, getting into the game, getting their crowd buzzed up a little bit. Substitution of who that is after my system update. Oh, it's Ninka Hintzberger. Nice and smooth. Jonker just saw the gap for Kunz to run into, gave it to him, and even though he mishandled first, it made it just being a more impressive looking shot in the end. The pass from Daphne van der Buschen, not great. Serious looking guy, that Glenn Powell's. Hintzberger, straight into a shooting roll off the back of the Korf. And the ball eventually bubbles free to Borgerhout. Still five down, but at least they're in the game now. Oh, Yeah, I think that was Elke Leden, just got the way through, hands went in, so she's got round Sana van der Werf, and there might have been an initial foul, and I think there's probably a second foul as well as she was reaching to try and recover Sana van der Werf was. And Elke Leden looks like she got a little bit of a hit in the nose, which raises the challenge of the make it and take it philosophy. Yeah, okay, so she got the hand in the face early. Yeah, there. That's good replaying from Brian Coppola, our producer, doing a good job. Elke Leden does a good job putting that away. The IKF coverage is just getting better and better. It's great to see him focusing on stuff like that. Ben Hueligan. Nice. Just smooth. Like, so they get a boy to go in, they get a girl to come round, a boy on the outside to shoot, and it make it look very simple at times. Bodies in around the post. Yarrow Painters. Oh! He got Yoma Yoka in the air. He took the hit on the hand. The ball went down. He read it well. Bounced it forward. Actually didn't bounce it really. No question of travelling. He's just on his, just lifted off his front foot. Nice little underhand. Well, we call it a running in shot style shot when you do it from a little bit closer. But that's a nice goal. And now suddenly Borgerhout are only four behind. This really won't be because Pakistan are letting up and letting them score goals, because they don't really tend to do that very much. Well, they might do it in the last couple of minutes, but they're certainly not doing it in the second quarter. Gunst again to Jonker from the setup of Amagasti at the side, just driving Gunst forward rather than backwards, and it's ending up with what Borgerhout prefer their shot to be, Jelmer Jonker taking it going away rather than Gunst from the direct for the free pass. That was a nice looking move from Daphne van der Boscher. Romy de Vrijke to Jelmer Jonker. And Ninka Hinsberger drives in, and Yarrow Peters with his typical emotional style, he thinks that the girls got there. Well, maybe they did. That's a difficult call for the referee when it gets a little bit messy like that. And Yelma Jonker's just trying to explain it to him as Ninka Hinsberger tucks it away. Haven't seen any penalties missed, I think, yesterday. I didn't watch all of the PKC to Schildegen game, but seems like now that everybody has to take penalties, everyone, yeah, it's taken a couple of seasons, but everyone's looking like, you know, they can score every time they step up there. Glenn Powells, who just was a little bit too clever for his feeder. Nice ball from Kunst to Hinsbergen. And again, Kunst, he just, oh, beautiful. He read the ball as it's coming to him, could have waited and took his shot, decided just to make it a little bit more beautiful, turning it into a rolling off the top of his hand, running in shot. Nice. Did Schroeder. Just when I thought Borgerhout were getting back into the game, PKSA just stretch their legs again and take the lead out to seven. And that's Jonker fouling Peters, so it's going to put Yanni Amagasti on the free pass line. Split formation, girls on each side, and Peters going to come and try and feed off that, but he didn't have any chance with Jonker in good position. Nicely timed feed from Sana van der Werf, but the pass out's not great. They're going to have to build again. And the boys not going out too far. Well, that's a tactic that a lot of players will play on Oliver Weingarten, on the assumption that his outside shot is not as good as the danger that he poses when he drives inside. Pakistan spectators. Nice. But kind bounce for PKC. Nice, to Manuel again, just from the setup from the 2-2, and they're attacking it straight away, and Zita Schroeder gets round and almost converted, and in the end, LFM Weingarten picks up the loose ball and drops it down quite nicely from 3 or 4 metres. Okay, Roy Van Laken just trying to float the ball over the top, trying to see if they can stretch the defence a little bit, and in the end he overstretched it and threw it off. Smooth little ticky-tacker between the players now. Khan's got his player just moving, and Jelmer Jonker goes for the two-footed, two-handed jump shot, and Kunz leans out and jumps out, nowhere near defended. But that shot quite often does hit the front. Roy Van Laken tries the little fake, and now it's going back out to Glenn Powell's. Tempo from PKC is good, but I suppose with good tempo occasionally goes some rash passes, and that from Jonker wasn't great. Again, the whole division's working hard to get some passing lanes, but it just really, PKC defence is good. Van Hooligan now is going to have to come and cut that off. Boys switch. But Van Weingarten uses athleticism and height to be able to pull that down, perhaps a little bit out of position. Kunz. They release the ball so quickly after a collect. Just as they hold on to that one just a little bit. And yeah, fantastic tempo. Beautiful ball. And a great goal from Romy de Rijker. Just really, the defenders just didn't really know where the ball was or what was going on, because every time they get the ball, they're releasing it and they're moving it, they're trying to put it over somebody's head. Pals. Pals again. Can't get it back. Kunz on the outside. That's his feeding ground. That's where he made his reputation. That is of one of the best players in the world. That if you put him outside, he will generate shots. And he will score a lot of those shots, but he will take them whether he's on good form or bad form, and he'll take them at a good time. And in the end, I think it was Roy Van Laken. No, that's a scene down there. Was it Yanni Omagasti? Just didn't quite catch him on the edge of the screen. Van Laken covers well against Van Hooligan. Van der Werf. Eventually breaks for Powell's. Maybe one last Borgerhout attack. No, it's not. They've thrown it away. Now it's going to be Van Weingarten. It's going to go in. Floats it to Ian Manhueligan, who drops it down after the long roll around. And that all came from the mishandle, which was what shaping to be Borgerhout's last attack. And another good goal where the combination between the PKC players is good. And that's probably, I thought it was going to be the last shot, but that must be the last shot from Glenn Powell's. And an interesting effort there from Roy Van Laken. Okay, interesting first half. PKC definitely on top. Wow, 18 goals in 20 minutes is pretty good. Borgerhout didn't look like they'd shown up today, but eventually they've got going. Come back in 10 minutes time for the second half.
Take that.
And we're back for the second half of Champions League Round 3, the final between PKC and Borgerhout. PKC came out strong and lived up to their status as favourites coming into this game. And it was a while before I actually thought that we were going to see a Borgerhout goal. They did eventually get going though. And there was one stage in the first half where I was optimistic that they were starting maybe just to find some rhythm. But in the end, the strength of PKC, in particular around the core, in particular their movement and their passing, ridiculously easy at times, and they scored 18 goals, which is pretty good in the half. We're looking at a big total from them. I don't think they're going to have much sympathy for Borgerhout, who's pretty much the home team here, and I know it's in front of their fans. They won't try and humiliate them, but they're here to play Korfball. Belgian fans like to see Korfball played, and there's not many teams play as well as PKC, but let's see how Borgerhout can go in the second half. There's Kunst, an interesting move. I think he's top scoring at the moment in the game with four goals. Jaro Peters has got four as well. Ninka Hinsberger tries to make something happen as she drives towards the Korf, ends up being called defended. Crowd a little bit quieter than they were at the beginning of the game. And, there's a kind of an off rhythm shot. Was it from Glenn Powell's? He's finally smiling. I was just saying he's looking like a very serious young man in the first half, and the goal has brought his face to life. Great switch from one side of the court to the other. Ended up Ninka Hinsberger's shot. But in the end, despite protestations, the ball does end up with Borgerhout. Early into the setup, the 2-2, Powell's at the post, and Laken a long way out, being pushed out there by Van Hooligan. Ellen Say, number 8, came on as a substitute in the first half, end up no shot. Happened too often in the first half. Nice cross-court ball from Romy de Rijkert and into Hinsbergen. Gunst with his characteristics. I'm going to shoot. No, I'm not. I'm going to drive forward. Does it so well. Pakistan girls making themselves available. Nice little flick out to Yelma Yonker. Shoots well. Good fight for the post. Ninka Hinsberger having a little bit of a word with the referee. Thought she should have got something out of that. Yeah, good driving from Powell. So he is a long way out, though, and he needs the ball if he's going to do something. And Oliver Weingard gets in and breaks it down. Jonker, off-rhythm shot. Again, it's going to be Jonker. Again, he takes a little step forward and then comes back to take the shot. Oh, nice. Romy de Rijkert almost found a little bit of space against Elke Giesen. And Kunz again takes a shot from the outside. And in the end, it's Britt Say who collects it for Borgerhout. Jani Arbogasti gets it and pulls it down for Elke Ledent, who misses the running in shot. And now the ball gets thrown into the PKC attack. Nice expansive ball just to start the attack off. And Kunz looked like he was going to go to the post. Didn't go in there in the end. And Jaro Peters made a crucial interception. Quite sure what the PKC defense is doing that is making Borgerhout have to set up in this way, but I suppose they wanted to get the two girls on the inside, see if they could isolate the boys, see if they can keep them away from the post, because the PKC boys have been dominating the collect so far. Kunst works hard on the outside to get his space, and the ball in the end is cleaned up by the two Borgerhout boys. Charles trying to get something going with his drive on the inside, but wasn't read by the feeder. So it was Powell's. Whoever like him with the ball at the moment. Is that Yelmer Jonker coming off? Okay, so we're just bringing it back to, I think that the ball had gone over, and so we ended up with the free pass taken from the wrong place. We've got it right now, though. Run naked. Yes, great. 1-2 combination with Patriots on the side. Yeah, it definitely looks like they're trying to work a lot more with the boys on the outside just to keep the distance from the defenders to the core for as large as possible. It worked for them that time. Oliver Weingarten. Borgerhout passing the ball in deep. Now they've got the boys on the inside this time. As Brit say to Elke Gikis, another two girls, and ends up with Pacers. He's going to have a little run. Get his shot up. Not much happening in collect style, but yeah, excellent fight win from Britsay, but she can't control the pass as she flings it back onto the court. City Schroeder, nice. Sonne van der Werf been a little bit quiet, but that's the sort of shot that she takes all the time in Korfball League and scores. She tries to do the right thing every single time that I see her. And if her role is on the inside, she'll work on the inside. But every time she goes out and she gets off with that kind of shot, she takes a decent shot. And it's her first goal of the game. Yanni Magasti, and he ends up with Peters fighting Hinsbergen. Gets a decision. Looks like Sana's gone off. Oh, no. Slow start from PKSA to the half, or suppose slow from both teams. I think it's 2-1 to Borgerhout so far in the first 5.5 minutes of the quarter. Schroeder. Okay, Van Weingarten out of position, which he doesn't mind sometimes. He can do something, but it bounced kindly for Van Laken. Good work from Romy de Rijker. Getting in, breaking that up, and then letting it roll out for Pakistan ball. Oh, one shows one side, shows the other. Oh, and I think he got called for, as he was going around the first time, he reached his arm out. Here we'll get a good look at it here. He's round. I'm not quite sure what the ref saw there. Not to say that it wasn't there. It's great having two referees on the pitch. And Evergasti, he did do the one pass behind the back yesterday. Oh, nice turn from Peters. Borgerhout building a bit of an attack here. Going to be Peters on the outside against Jonker. Ball goes wide and short, but it ends up at Elke Giesen, and good fight from Amagasti. He does have to grab the post, so he's never going to end up with that anyway. And referee Peter Busing just having a little word with him, just saying cut that out. He knew he was beaten, having a bit of fun. Not a great Pakistan attack. As I say, they haven't started this quarter too well. Is it going to be enough to open the door for Borgerhout to get back into this game? Well, it's going to be difficult. And a kind of interesting thought from Elke Giesen, but it was easy for Kunst in the end. decent defence from Borgerhout. Yeah, just making it difficult for them to move the ball. Then in the end, I think it's a little bit, well, miscommunication means they ended up throwing it out, and looks like we've got another timeout. Not quite sure who called it. Might be a good time for a PKC timeout. Yes, it is from PKC. Like I said, they're not in their best spell of the game at the moment, and a big chance for Wim Shortmay to have a few words with them. Let's see if we can listen in. Okay, maybe he's taking his mic off. They're probably grateful to have a weekend off from Korfball League and come down here and join some club. I listened to Belgian coach. Not too late. Okay, so what can PKSA do in terms of just changing the momentum that they've had that's just stalled just a little bit in the last few minutes? They're starting by trying to block the ball coming out of defence, which teams will do from time to time, just try and change some rhythm. Paters, nice, kind bands, but well picked up by Amagasti. Paters again, and Kunst reads it well off the Korf, and that looks like that's Powell's, Glenn Powell's is down. He has got some taping on his knee, so I'm wondering if that's a recurrence of that injury. It's not heavy taping. No, it looks like it might be a groin injury, which can be very painful. Remember, most of these Belgian Borgerhout players, they played 30 to 40 minutes of reasonably hard Korfball yesterday. They should be fit enough to do this, but sometimes injuries happen. Okay, he's up. And I think the little claps that he's giving indicate that he might be on the way out. Okay, yeah, so it looks like we're just a little bit of a delay while Borgerhout get a substitute ready. Oh no, he's going back out. No, so he is going to be replaced. And that's Carney Gerlow. Alright, back into the Korfball. Early shot, almost missed it. Was it Betsuweg? Yes, it was. Oh, and a little bit of pressure from Elke Leden. Still manages to get it up and in. Amagasti. Good combination between the boys. Nice long passes. And there was an interesting break from the post from Romy de Rijker. Looks like Kunz didn't quite read it properly. Desiree Schroeder picks herself up off the floor. And the shot from Van Laken is picked up by Zudvik. Nice. Linka Hinsberg breaking from the back of the Korf, and Paters does well against the challenge of Jonker. Pakistan continuing to make the Borgerhout work to bring the ball out of defence. Nice, good drive. Ended up with two girls defending Elke Ledent, and I suppose it was called defended in the end. Okay, that's the slump of the shoulders there from Romy DeVrijke after she threw that out. They're definitely not in a good spell of the game. They've only scored two in this quarter, and if Booger hadn't managed this clock correctly, then PKC won't have much more than a very fleeting chance to do something. Well picked up by Ellen Say. Oh, the one-handed shot, not great. And eventually we do wind down to the end of the third quarter, and I think that was probably 2-2, so really not a great quarter of top international korfball. However, the game is pretty much won for PKSA, so it's difficult for both teams just to find their best form at the moment. Let's have a listen to the coach.
Maken een fantastische eerste aanval. Moeten we focussen. Kim perfect met Ellen starten. Wat moeten we doen? We moeten met alle gevieren kort bij de korf proberen komen. Zet kort bij de korf, dan schiet hem. Maar dat komen met vier gaat verplaatsen, is de kans vrij groot. Dat je met even groot als mijn staat is hij wel. Dus probeer kort bij de korfje. Ze biedt bij Ellen. Je moet het even gaan zien dat je het kan doen. Maar focus niet alleen op die rebound. Probeer kort te komen en gewoon de juiste kans te gaan nemen. Maar niet te snel. Ook weer niet te snel in je aanval. Maak het tussen van 12 en 0. Iets gooi dat pak.
Oké, het is Sven Vervloot. Number 25 has come on. I enjoyed his little cameo that he had at the end of the game yesterday. I think everyone knows the result of this game now, and it's going to be PKC the winner. But let's see who can play a nice, stylish last 10 minutes to entertain this korfball-loving crowd in Belgium. Jonker, not a well-timed shot. Turn from Elke Le Dent, picked up by Van Laken. Room on the outside, and Van Hoeligan just gets his hand in, and they got 9 seconds on the shot clock. And Yanni Omagasti, nice, just manages to get it up, and it's a good shot, but it bounces kindly from the Ian Van Hoeligan. Waiting for Kunst. And Navy, he draws his player, gets the ball back, out to Jonker, drops it down. Now that's the sort of PKSA goal that they gives them back the confidence in who they are and what they can do. Van Laken. Feed from Ledent, out to Van Laken again. Good shot, good goal. That's a better Borgerhout attack. Ben Zuvrek out to Oliver Meingarden. Nice. Gives it back to Van Hoeligan. And in the end, it comes to Borgerhout. Maybe just lacking the hunger that goes with, you know, having to win the game. They know that they've won the game. Strong collection from Romy DeVrijke. Girls on the outside. Nicely timed feed from Zita Schroeder, and was a good collect before she got fouled. Schroeder, Van Meingarden, so strong, really good control on his hands when he extends as well, so he makes the ball available. Van Hoeligan gets the ball back from Zoetweg. And misses wide. Look at that crowd just trying to get the last bit of energy out of their team. You know, they play good level Korfball week in, week out, but you don't get to see a team like PKC cross the border down to Belgium too often. So they want to see their team do as well as possible against you know, one of the top three or four teams in the world, you'd have to say, you know, if not the best, some will make it. And that's a lovely little move from Sven Vervloot. And Richard Kunz just going for the block. Oh, interesting penalty technique from Sven, but effective information. Sudvek, nice. Once again, great control after the feed. The ball goes straight out and it becomes alive again. And that's not great from Lukasita Schroeder. Thought she was fouled. She's trying to pass out. Peters, off balance. He seems to be off balance all the time, moving quickly, and yeah, he just acknowledging to his teammates it wasn't a great time to shoot. Schroeder. Any time that the ball's bouncing around there, Oliver Weingarten will come looking for it and try and do something with it when he finds it. And the shot from space, off rhythm from Zudvek, goes long and is collected by Borgerhout. Peters decides not to shoot this time. He's going to drive. Two-footed jumping back shot, and he looked disappointed with himself when it didn't go. Pretty difficult shot. Arjen van Heuligen just going to quite kindly wait for his opponent to get up. Won't necessarily see that happen in Korfball League too often, but it's just a trip, you know. Really, if you want to come down here and you want to beat your player, that's not really the way that you want to be seen to be doing it. Showed an early shot off the collect. So that's what they do so well. Oliver Weingarten collects it. Already Schroeder's in position. Doesn't stay long on his hand. Boom, and it's out. Schroeder knows what he's going to do. That she's going to get a ball right in the spot. She's going to take that shot. Van Heuligen's going to come looking for it if it doesn't go in straight away. And Sven Vervloot, this is going to be a good challenge for him. And Romy de Rijken just almost turned that into a goal and ends up with a referee's decision. I think it's going to be a penalty for Romy de Rijken. But she very competently tucks away, and the PKC lead gets bigger. At least they've got going now after that poor third quarter they had. It was a good move from Yanni Omagasti. Wasn't quite red though, Van Laken. Never mind, out there to Van Laken again. Good fight going on at the post, won by Van Weingarten. Long, long bomb down to the other end. It's going to end up with Romy de Rijken. And say, and then Mugasti. Okay, good attack. And Elkala dead, just drew Zita Schroeder onto her, and then just added the little flurry of the shot at the end, just in case the referee didn't get the message. And she misses penalty, which is sad. I haven't seen one in this tournament so far. Kunst, nice, smooth. Always got an answer. Jonker owning the post there as well. Britse, nice. Finds herself a little bit of space. Gets a nice ball, looks like enjoying a goal, good to see. Renhuelligan. Oh, I see the shot ended up. She knew that was coming back from Olav. Just snatched it at it just a little bit. Nice man, McLeod gets in the air. And the referee gives an early call of the penalty. I think that's the right move. He's got the option to let that go on. But as he goes round, yes, I think the foul was probably on Romy de Rijker. But with Sven Vervoet, his second goal, his second celebration. Excellent. Great move from Romy de Rijker. Now Nika Hinsberg. Jelma Jonker just almost turned that into a spectacular goal. A little bit messy from Borgerhout, but they do get Hammergaster going round. Van Lycken's free at the back. Takes a good shot and. Once again, the ever-present Olivan Weingarten pulls down another defensive rebound. Kunsten Jonker. Jarrow Peters looked a bit awkward once he claimed it, but he did well to get there. Magaste and not gonna go. What can Pankase show us in these last couple of minutes? Ninka Hinsberg from range. Well picked up by Jonker, great tempo. Lovely tiki taka. Ninka Hinsberg just a long way out. Good scrap going on at the post. Wasn't important in the end. Foul by Van Hoeligen and Van Laken and we'll put Amagaste to the line. Has to go a long way to take that shot and in the end it falls short. Nick Hinsberger got his shooting boots on now at the moment from that range. Again, always looking to shoot. Well pulled down by Kunst. Nice. Beautiful. Good attack. Good rebound. It should be a player free. And defense just about recovers. It's going to be Hinsberger again. No, she just a little bit too much pressure on that. It's going to be Jonker taking the shot. Hinsberger again. Kunst. Need a reset. Get a reset. And Jonker, just in the spirit of trying to keep the ball flowing, tries something just a little bit beyond maybe his abilities there, or the situation. Van Lycken, able to shoot them. Yes, excellent position from Yanni Omagasti. I was surprised that he didn't shoot initially. We were just getting a better grip on the ball. And shot from Van Lycken, it's good, but Van Weingarten cleaning up again in the middle. Last couple of attacks. Romy de Rijker, I've enjoyed watching her play today. I think she's just new at PKC. Jonker, he's really kind of got this buzz on him at the moment. They just want to move it. They want to play with style. Well done by Romy de Rijker. Ends up with Jelma Jonker. A little bit awkward with his shot, but he's pulled it down again. And Linka Hinsbergen's going to take her shot. And Borgerhout finally get it back. 10 seconds to go in the quarter, in the game. Ebergasti goes for the long range shot from the corner, but it is no good. And in the end, it wasn't embarrassing for a Borgerhout. They just got beaten by a better team today. It looked like it was going to be a shocker in the first quarter. PKC played very well, did everything that they needed to do. Their third quarter performance wasn't great, but you know they proved everything they needed to prove in the first quarters and ran out easy winners. So both teams now go forward to I believe it's February the 11th. It's going to be in Delft. Delft in the Netherlands. Four big teams. You've got to keep checking back with the IKF channels just to see when that one's going to go. I'll be commentating on that. I hope to see you there. Hope you've enjoyed the tournament. Good luck. Bye-bye.